Hello friends, how are you all? This is Dr. Rohini here, and as per the request from some of my non-Kannada friends, today I'm going to start my videos in English too, so that more people will get benefited by these videos. Thank you so much friends for the suggestion. In my last videos, I had given a detailed information about the primary prevention of cervical cancer, that is about the HPV vaccination. In my today's video, I'm going to give you information about the secondary prevention of cervical cancer. What do you mean by secondary prevention? So, picking up the disease in a stage when it is in the precancerous stage or in a very early cancer stage, the tests which we are going to do, those tests, I'm going to talk about those tests today. Why it is important to do this test? Because if you pick up the disease in a precancerous stage or in early stage, this cervical cancer is 100% curable. So, don't you think it is important to do this test? Definitely, it is important. As I told you in my previous videos, once the HPV viral infection happens, there is a gap of almost 15 or 20 to 30 years. It takes around 20 to 30 years to get converted into actual disease of cervical cancer. So making use of this opportunity, making use of this time gap, we are trying to pick up this disease in a precancerous or early stage. The screening test which we do to pick up the cervical disease at this stage is called papsmear, and another test is HPV viral test. These tests are called a screening test because we are doing this test when there is no symptoms of cervical cancer. So in the coming videos, I'm going to give you all the details about when we are going to do the test, how we are going to do the test, who has to compulsory do the test and who don't have to do the test. All this information will be there in my coming videos. So what exactly we do in the pap smear? The neck of the womb, the opening of the cervix, there is a area called as a transformation zone, and this is the exact area where the cervical cancer starts with. So when we take a small brush and we scrape some of the cells from this transformation zone and we send it for the test. So when we see those cells under the microscope, when we do the viral test, we come to know whether there is any HPV viral infection or there is any precancerous lesions, or if there is a cervical cancer, whether it is at the early stage or it is spread beyond the cervix. So all this information we get from this simple test, and this test is very simple and it doesn't cause any pain or any discomfort, and if you go to any qualified gynecologist, they will do this test for you. And the next point is when we are going to start doing this test. As per the American Cancer Society, we need to start screening a woman from the age of 25. And according to ACOG, American College of Obs and Gyne, we have to start from the age of 21. Just to avoid this confusion, I'll give a simple tip that when you're supposed to start doing the screening, whether you're married or not married, it doesn't matter. What is the most important point is, are you sexually active? Once you start your sexual life, after 3 years, you should commence doing this screening test. So once you start doing the test, you should do this test every 3 years. Most of the hospitals will have the facility of the pap smear, but HPV test will not be available in all the hospitals. So when you do only a pap smear, you can do it every 3 years. But when you combine a pap smear with HPV test, it's okay. You can do the you have to do the test every 5 years. So till what age you are going to continue doing this test? If you are regularly doing the test every 3 years, then, and if all the tests are normal, then at the age of 65, you can stop doing the test. But if you have not started doing this test in an early age, or if you have started doing this test very late, or if you have got any doubtful results or abnormal results in the pap smear or anything, then you may have to continue doing this test till 75 or 80 years age, because the cervical cancer can happen even after 60 years or 70 years of age. As we all know that in many places, in the especially in the remote villages, places like that where you don't have much facilities and there is no much awareness also. In such situation, as per the WHO, the woman can start screening for the test at least by 30 years of age, and if they cannot do the test once in 5 years or once in 3 years, at least they can do it at least once in 10 years. And some of the women may not be able to regularly do the test, and if such women can do the pap smear test at least once or twice in her lifetime, even that also is very helpful in picking up the disease if it is in an early stage or anything, and it is very helpful to pick up or even to prevent the stage, the disease going to an advanced stage. So this is about when you're supposed to do the test, and in my coming videos I'm going to give you all the details about how to do the test and what time you have to do the test and when not to do the test. All these details I'm going to give you in my next videos. Till then, take care. Bye.